Now let's welcome Professor Yiping Lin from National Jiao Tong University. The speech is entitled IoT Applications on Smart City, the IoTtalk Approach. Let's welcome.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So I'll give the talk about smart city. So the most important thing for a smart city is that you need a IoC. What is IoC? IoC is integrated operation center. Okay. So we built an IoC through Google Map and put all the application on the map. Okay. For example, in National Jiao Tong University, we have a bus. Okay. We have the bus application, and then through the map, you see where there are three bus, and you know the location of the bus, and then now you know when you can take a bus. Okay, so this is one thing, and you can hide all these bus and go to another application. For example, we can go to the building, and this is the square. Garden between the engineering building. Let's take some time. Let's try another one. Through all those sensor value. This is a small aquarium, but through the experiment in this small aquarium, we have a very huge fish pump. Based on this experiment. Turn on the light. And then, you can pump the air if you don't have enough air in the water, something like that. But let me tell you, the most important sensor in fish pond or aquarium is ammonia sensor. Okay, it's quite tough, it's a difficult one. And we solve it and we publish a paper there. You can read the paper to learn how we do it, okay? So this is an application. So this is a fish pump. This is a water pump. And you can control it like this. Okay. So actually, the first thing in smart city is that you just move the switch from the wall to your smartphone. Okay. So what we have here is a web-based control. So use the smartphone's browser, you can always control the switches for the smart application. But this is just the first step. I'll show you how we actually do the application. through this very simple control. Now turn off the water. And then what we can do is, we have many smartphones. Okay, let me show. This is turmeric, very high value plant. We sell with a very good price. Okay, and then you can see that they are. Actually, we go in the soil and the different soil box. And the reason we do that is that for each box, we'll give a different condition and see how those conditions affect the growth of the plant so we can do the AI. Okay, let me show you. There's a lot, some control. Because this is a fun place, so the network facility is not so good, and you take some time when you do the control. And this time is pretty quick actually. So you can see that this is a yellow light. And during the night, you need the light to give the plant leaf those light intensity. But when you do that, those moths, insects will come to eat the leaf, okay? So what we do is the yellow light, meaning that those blue light spectrum won't be, it's disappear. So what those insects, when the insect come into the fang field, you can see anything, so you will leave, okay? And here, I just show you that I can control all these actuators in the fang field. And when we do this smart farming, actually, those actuators are controlled by the sensors. And we have following sensor. And you can see this is all real time. Let's see, CO2. Okay, so you can see all those data for CO2, and then all those information can use to control the actuator. Okay. And we have another farm. In the southern part of island, Tainan. Somewhere here. Actually, this is a high-speed tram, okay? And on the left here, that's the all those sensor value for the Tainan farm. Let me see what happened to the Tainan farm. So you can see that actually IoT is not so perfect in the farm field, okay, because the network facility is not that good. We can try later. It's a small greenhouse in the mountainside. Okay, who's this guy? Who there? Okay, we are growing. This is a white strawberry. Let me see what I can do. Ah. Okay. Now they don't want me to see them. Okay. Give up. Okay, so remember the IoT application has this privacy issue, okay? This is the phone we have right now.
We have one in Philippines. Actually, we have one in Armenia, but I'm not quite sure why up here. We have one phone in Armenia, and we have one in Okinawa, Japan. Okay, we have about 10 phones in Taiwan here. Okay, so you can see there's many things we can do.
Especially when there's the COVID-19, we use a lot of this smart application. For example, in the class, this is the class I taught last semester, okay? Because COVID-19, the students can take the lecture anywhere. We don't want that to people to be together in a classroom. So we allow them to take lecture and use video streaming. So the students of my class, it's about, let me see how many students here. It's about 150 students in the class. And they can take the class, lecture everywhere in Taipei, in Taiwan, okay? And when they want to watch the video, they have to register so we know exactly where they are. And there's no privacy issue because the students have to tell us where they are. And I can even know what happened to a student like this. Tina. Tina, this student actually live in Taichung. Okay, so every week he has to transmit to Hsinchu, to the university. Okay, so we have some information and we know exactly how they move for COVID-19. And again, there is no privacy issue. Okay, so the good thing about IoT is that you can do a lot of application, use whatever sensor to come up a lot of smart application. Okay. And the most important sensor is actually your smartphone. Okay, smartphone has so many sensors that you can use to check all those people. Actually, we use it for a voting application. Let me show you how we do the voting. The sensor is your smartphone, okay? So in IoT, you have sensor, you have actuators, okay? So in the voting application, your smartphone, okay, you can use a soft switch to do the voting, okay, and then you can see the result. The result part is the actuator. It still go to your smartphone. So let me show you how we do it. No music.
Okay, let me do it again.
You can create a voting issue through our website. You can post the issue. So the issue here is that do you like to drink wine? One says yes, option two is no. So you have multiple choice. And then you use your smartphone as the sensor to connect to the network. You just scan the QR code, then you go to the location. First one, water says yes. And this water says no. Now, the third water. Yes, again, so this is a final book, something like that. And through the IoT technology, you can make the voting process more interesting. Let me show you how we do that. So every small piece here is a vote, okay? If you vote yes, you will show the small piece and they will collect together, become the flower. And you can use your smartphone to control the movement of the flower. So you can see that you move back. Okay. And see the smartphone to the opposite direction. And people continue to do the voting. So you become bigger and bigger. And you can say, okay, this ball does not count. You can do it again. So you can see that through the IoT technology, you can play, make the voting process quite interesting. Okay. Now, besides that, we just use it for a theater. Okay, let me show you what happened.
I'm Max Schumacher, Max Schumacher in German, and I'm the co-artistic director of a company called Post Theater. We have been invited to co-create here the performance Nonuments, which I am also the theater director of and the author of the script for the production. The idea of the performance Nonuments is that the audience can create a monument. So in a democratic way, they are asked to think, design, and work on a fictional monument for Japan to commemorate the era of the Japanese colonialism in Taiwan.
He's talking about the history of the world. When we have technology, it actually gives us every peasant and citizen 历史的书写权跟话语权，你可以透过手机表达你的意见，你可以说日本人是侵略国，或者你觉得日本人是你的好朋友，因为他毕竟在殖民的那段时间里面建设了台湾，可是他也屠杀了很多的人。可是我们现在就很少去想这些问题，所以这个作品基本上透过 手机互动，透过一个所谓的AI polling system，你可以现场投票，马上及时运算，然后130个人的意见被以很民主的方式呈现在你的面前，然后我们来决定我们要盖什么样的纪念碑，我们要在纪念碑的下面怎么样落款，这样的一个表演的过程，我们其实是在用一个多媒体的方式，也可以说我们是在用一个非常科技的方式
I want the audience to really think of a monument. I want them to really design and reflect what a monument could be like. The great thing about this performance is that no matter what happens, it's interesting. So I have no preconception what kind of monument the audience will be designing. As long as they design one, I'm fine. Yeah? as long as the technology doesn't crash on us, there will be a result, and that will be interesting and worth discussing. So I think the project cannot really fail, but the biggest frustration for me is that I only learn whatever is translated from me.
平民百姓是不是应该在历史书写上被给予一个位置，而不是只有一个官方的说法？我们都来自不同的地方，我们有不同的历史的观点，可是我们现在都在这里了。那既然我们都在这里了，我们是不是应该要彼此去尽量去理解对方怎么看历史，怎么把自己放在一个很大的一个历史的脉络里面？我们都应该要去想想看，我们曾经参与过哪些事情，我们怎么样用我们自己台湾人的观点来理解在这个土地上发生过的事情。
Okay, so what happened here is that we use an IoT platform called IoTtalk. So with this IoTtalk, over 100 audience can get together to make a decision to build a monument. Okay.So actually, IoT is very powerful because you can collect a lot of information together to finish a task. Now, let me show you our application on smartphone, agriculture. Microwave station, we have built two. This is the second one. Okay.
So take a look on this microwave station.
It's robust, and the pole is a heavy duty one.
We also have a
very good microwave station from United States. This is probably the best one from the United States. Okay. But unfortunately, we cannot use it in Taiwan. Okay, do you know the reason why? Take a look on this microwave station. And this one. You see the difference? In Taiwan, we have many typhoons, right? When a typhoon comes, this microwave station can survive. And this microwave station cannot. So that's the difference. Okay? So because we are doing this organic planting, so our farm field is typically in a very difficult location. This is one of the smart farm we built on the mountain slope. Okay. So imagine how do we harvest this farm field? Okay, we have to use another IoT technology with a robot, okay, to do the thing, to the whole thing. Otherwise, it's a very heavy duty work here.
Let me show you another
farm field. This is a small one, but we put a lot of microwave station. So you can see here is a weather station. And then here is another weather station. Here's another weather station. This is another one, and another one, okay? So, actually, smart agriculture is not that easy, okay? This is an experimental farm, and we put various sensors on the air and in the soil, and do the different placement and see all the effects and to find an optimal way to put a sensor in the front field. Okay, and actually we have this is in Chinese, but you can see that how you put a sensor to do the soil analysis is not a trivial, okay? You have to put a sensor in the right distance, and so you have to do some accurate measurement so that your sensor will give you the best measurement, okay? So this is what we have done for smart agriculture. Now, let me show you another thing. We have also do that on, you know, unfortunately, right now is COVID-19. So this tiny cute animal is not popular anymore. Okay, that's a bat. This is a very rare species, okay, that we can find in Taiwan. And we have done a lot of analysis to study this bat, okay, through our IoTtalk technology. Okay. Let me see. So what we try to do here is actually to see how temperature and humidity affect those bed cloud. Okay. You can see different is in this area. Okay, take a look. The beds are in this area. And we use the IoT technology to measure the environment inside and then decide how this condition affect the behavior of the bat. So this is another thing we do. And that's another thing that Professor Chen Huan Chen, he will give the third talk. And this is very interesting. We do the project together. Do you know what we are doing now? This is honeybee. Oh, should go to the next. And what? When you want to handle this, those bees, you have to put smoke lamp, put a smoke, so their movement will become slower. Become dormant, so you can do whatever you want to do with this tiny insect. Professor Chen is building a micro camera in this box, so you can study the behavior of the those bees. Okay, put more smoke so you can pull out a slice here. And the video I show here is still, we just do that manually, and eventually they will be replaced by IoT technology. Okay, I think we have, this is how Professor Chen built, okay, their IoT sensor built in the box. Now, let's take a look on another demo. Department store. You know, in the department store, the popular product is cosmetic product, okay? You have to attract your customer and do some makeup and persuade them to purchase. But in COVID-19, how do you do that? That's how we do, okay? So, those young lady will use this remote communication and to explain their product. And then they'll ask you, they will tell you how you put the makeup through this remote technology. So they try to put the lipstick and my eye makeup. And this is all those image processing technology, okay, with the AI, okay. You have to detect accurately and put those makeup accurately on your face to see the exact effect as the actual makeup put on your face. Otherwise, the customer are not happy and won't purchase your product. Oh, the young lady did a lot of things on my face, so I just move faster in order to change the color of my lips. Let me see the final result. How do I look? Okay. So, okay, so after COVID-19, many IoT technology become very popular, okay? Let me show you, so this department store and education, okay? We did a lot of education stuff here. We are teaching programming and using IoT technology. 声音可以出来吗? That's how we teach primary school students those farming center impact on the weather and the tree. So right now it's dark, so if you put the light on the farming sensor, okay, so it becomes cloudy and daylight. Okay, if you remove the light, you change it again. Put some water, you spray water on the sensor, and the tree grow. Okay, so you can, this is all IoT talk technology, and you can play a lot of things. Let me see, there's many IoT, and you can integrate that with Scratch. And the good thing about smartphone is that basically, because everybody has one, so for all those applications, it's free, okay? So when we teach students how you can use IoT to do the program, actually there is no extra cost, okay? This is more complicated Scratch programming, and in this environment, we build a Scratch extension for IoTtalk, so you can connect them to play. I'll skip the detail, but you can catch what I think. So we also use that for high school physics experiment. For example, again, you scan the QR code. Okay, so then you put your smartphone on a chair. So what are you going to do? This is a high school student's experiment. Okay, they are very innovative. Guess what kind of experiment they are doing? That's a Python program written by a high school student. Now, start the experiment. So do you know what kind of experiment they are doing? Okay. The smartphone will collect its location information sent to the IoT system, the IoTtalk system, now go to the animation. So now you have the experiments, and you have all the data to plot, compare your experiment data, okay, with the theoretical curve. Okay, so you can see the image of the curve. So that's how the student do the experiment, and it's free, okay, because they use their smartphone. A lot of team, but I'll skip.
So what do I have here?
Elevator. So how can we play with elevator using the IoT technology? Okay. My idea is very simple. I want to use a smartphone to control the elevator, meaning that you can use a smartphone to press which floor you want to go. And we feel that this is a very good idea. And go to the elevator manufacturer, and they said, you are crazy, who want this kind of application, okay? You just press the button on the elevator, right? We already have all those buttons, so it's not practical. But after COVID-19, those elevator manufacturers come to me and say, okay, we want a solution, because they don't want the passenger to touch the panel. So they say, okay, you just touch your smartphone to do that. But we can do much better than that. So this is the
永大电梯 Neural 客流智能管理系统
OK
庞大的客流压力与日益增长的输送需求 已成为高层电梯面临
So in a traditional elevator there are four cars. So everybody, when one car open, then everybody run into that the car. And second one open, then get in. And everyone, people, the passenger just press all the floor. So until the last one, you wait such a long time. So frustrated, right? Now, with the IoT technology, what you can do is that through some smart scheduling, you can dispatch the passenger, okay, of the same destination to the same car, okay. So for people go to car A, will go to the same floor, and B is another different same floors, okay. So you can see that the number of stop reduced, okay, and everybody happy because you don't need to stop on every floor. So with the IoT technology, you can dispatch the passengers to the right cars so they can go to their destination without minimal stops. Okay, so it's a very simple idea. But very useful. to the next application. Frame. So we use frame to do a lot of things. For example, this is in the history class. The student can use a smartphone to interact with a historical figure and guess who the people in the frame, which historical figure is in the frame. For example, this one, you know who he is, right? Okay, so that's what we do with the friend. And we can, the smart friend, you can interact with it through the song, okay? You know, it's just the friend, and we just make a noise, and you play with you. And you can do better. So this ball will change its shape with your voice. Seems that I don't have much time, so I'll skip. Okay, so this now, when the prototype is done, we just put it on the... we have an AI program, okay? So the change of picture will follow your music. So for example, if you use another music, okay, and you can use a smartphone to play with the with a friend.
How?
And then when you wave your hand, those vibrate will move to the direction you move. And this is all IoT technology that we use in a smart application. And you now the left hand, so you see the left part. You move to the left side. Okay, now you got some idea, right?
That's
another thing that you can use smartphone to play with the object inside the frame.
So you shift. 然后，荧幕上的图案会根据你晃动手机的幅度来改变它的。
Okay, so if you shape, then you change shape or change color. I think right now he's trying to change the color from red to I guess it's yellow. You see, now it's yellow, right? And now different way of shaping, then the object shape change. And you can move your cell phone up or down, and the object will rotate in different direction. All these are IoT technology. Now you can see the moving direction clearly with this object. Okay. Okay. I just show you how I control the water pump, the real time and in National Chiao Tung University. Let me show you how it is done here. Let me see. It's I guess it's this one, right? So this is the water pump. I just show you. So the music through the IoT technology, you can easily control the light and the water spray. So, in National Chiao Tung University, we ask the student to do the project on all those IoT platforms, and they can build their own application to control everything on campus. They can show their innovation. I think Professor Zhao, you must know where it is, right? That's in your 公司館. The building, right? And the students are very innovative. And the color represent a score. It's they have to decode to know their score of their final test. Okay. So when the color of light change, actually, it will tell you your midterm or final score. Okay. That's how we do. You have to do decoding. Okay, now you see the water pump again. So the student do the project here. Basically, they just try to do the electric fence. So when people move into the square, the red square, the water spray will activate. So you take a look, the water, the fountain, is activate with the people when you move around. Okay, so when she moved to another square, then the second spray and the first one stop, something like that. So if you want to make a smart city, you need to give a platform and let people to play their application to show their innovation there, okay? And you can see a lot of interesting things. Let me see, what else do I have? You know, voice activation, right? This is how we do.
Shape of You by Ed Sheeran.
中华。
Last piece I want to show you. Okay, you can use IoT technology to control your door. See? You can use it as a display. You see this side? Okay, I guess my time. Time is up, right? Okay, thank you very much.
Let's thank Professor Lin once again for his inspiring speech. Well, because we do have a tight schedule, if the speaker does not have time to answer your question, please feel free to ask him or her your question by email. Thank you for attending. The next session will begin at 3 right here in this room.